Good morning. Welcome to worship with the First United Church of Christ Congregational of Milford, Connecticut, as we celebrate our music ministry today. A special welcome to those who are relatively new to our worshiping community, both in person and online. If you are newish here, we would love for you to fill out a visitor card and place it in the offering plate later in the service. Everyone is invited to a time of fellowship after worship in our fellowship hall on the first floor as we continue our celebration reception. And Ann Sabo is hosting today, so we are very grateful for her work. We do need volunteers to sign up during the summer to host coffee hour, and you can do that after the service. Just one Sunday is good. Okay, two if you want, but just one. Today, our children will be staying in worship, and there is an activity sheet in the bulletin. Ms. Kelsey invites you to bring that completed sheet up to her after worship to collect a prize. Great things are coming up. Next Saturday, June the 17th, visit Milford Green for Milford Celebrates Juneteenth activities to highlight Black history, culture, resilience, and the achievements as part of our National Day commemorating emancipation in the United States. The church office will be closed on June 19th in celebration. Next Sunday, June 18th, our summer worship time changes to 8 a.m. and 9:30 a.m., and later in the summer, we will shift to outdoor services for that 8 a.m. I now invite Marlene for a special announcement.
Good morning. With next Saturday being the earlier time to start church, what a better way than just to get out of bed and come to church as you are. It's pajama day. Christian Outreach is collecting new pajamas so that we can give them to the Boys and Girls Village in Milford for children who have been placed there. It's always nice to get a new set of pajamas when they're placed into that program. So whether you want to wear pajamas or you're not, or you want to bring a favorite stuffed animal to hang out with you during church service next week, you're welcome to do that, but please bring new pajamas, any size, from toddlers on up to adults, because kids come in all shapes and sizes. There'll be boxes in the narthex and down in Fellowship Hall. So from Christian Outreach, we thank you for your generous donations.
Thank you, Marlene. On June the 25th, our mission trip crew will be commissioned during the 8 a.m. service. We will then have a blessing over our group as we load up the vans to depart for Earlville, Maryland, where we will work at Deep Roots Incorporated to serve children and families who have dealt with homelessness. Also on June the 25th, we have Sunday school and our vacation Bible school program to start. And you can find details in your bulletin on participating. We give a great amount of thanks for our liturgists and our musicians today for all of the wonderful work over the year and in preparation for this special service. And now, with joy and love in our hearts, let us greet those near and far with God's peace. Peace be with you.
Now, will all who are able please rise for a responsive call to worship? It's time to prepare to sing God's praises. Even now, I can sense the rhythm inside us pleading to do its part. Sing different notes, yet as one. We are ready to praise the God of love and light, our source and goal of life. Remember, we're singing verses 1, 3, and 4.
Join in our prayer of invocation. Like children shaping their mouths as they learn to sing in key, we come now, God, hoping to shape our words and praises in ways that sing true to your love for us. May your Holy Spirit swell up within us like a beautiful note that longs to be sung. May your Spirit connect our voices in that mystic, sweet communion that only music can make possible. We pray this in the name of Jesus, whose voice utters those sweet words we love to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. You may be seated.
This church's vibrant music ministry is made possible by a combination of the time, talent, and treasure of this faith community, the time of our volunteers who put in so many hours of rehearsal the talents of those same people and the finances that help us maintain our pianos and our organs, pay for music ministers, sheet music, all those things. It really does take this whole community to sustain our music ministry. So let us consider how we can continue to support and lift up God in praise through our music ministry as this morning's tithes and offerings are given and received.
Please join in the prayer of dedication. Gracious God, All that we are and all that we have are gifts from you. Today we return a small portion of those gifts in these, our tithes and offerings. Bless these gifts and use them to spread your lyrical good news of love and hope to all the world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And your hymn is on the back of your bulletin.
Wow. That was great. Praise God for that. And give them a moment to make their way back to where they were previously. So this morning's scripture reading comes from Paul's first letter to the church in Corinth, chapter 13, verses 1 and then 7 in the first part of verse 8. So just to give you a little bit of background, so Paul was starting these new churches as the church and the Jesus movement was spreading out from Jerusalem across the Western world. So Paul makes his way to the city of Corinth in modern-day Greece. He starts this church with about 30 or 40 people, some of whom were raised Jewish, some of whom were not. And they come together, and they have their worship services in somebody's house, and everything is nice. And then Paul moves on to the next church to start. And meanwhile, somebody else helps him out there leading the church for a while. But then the people of that church have some tension, some conflict, and then they write Paul a letter looking for him to help out, because like I say, when two or three are gathered together, then you have at least four different perspectives on things. So Paul writes a letter in response to their letter, which we have as 1 Corinthians. And one of the controversies that seemed to be happening is that there was this debate over whose spiritual gifts were the most important. And it looked like some of the people said that this thing called glossolalia, this idea that you could speak in other languages, that was the most important gift. And Paul, at that point, decides to, in response, talk about the body of Christ and how all the different parts of the body are significant. And then at the end of chapter 12, he writes, "Strive for the greater gifts, and I will show you a still more excellent way." So listen now for God's word in these three verses from chapter 13. "If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends." May God rich blessings to this reading of Holy Word, and will you pray with me? O God, may we sing of your love forever. Amen. So, as many of you know, I am an amateur percussionist. I was thinking about the patience of being a percussionist. Oftentimes you get a piece of music and it has, like, as a percussionist, it has like 86 measures of rest, which is always fun. Because you're like, what are you going to do? And I was just thinking about this. I was borrowing this music stand from Steve Parrott, who was using it, and it was taking me back to my years in middle school. When you're a percussionist, you play different drums and stuff, and you got lots of time to contemplate the world. And I was like, oh, it's a Manhasset stand, which I always would joke, it made me think about Neil Armstrong. And people were like, why does it make you think about Neil Armstrong? Because it says, man has set. And so I would always think, man has set foot on the moon. This is the kind of thing that you think about when you're a percussionist, because you have a lot of time, a lot of spare time on your hands when you're counting 86 measures of rest. So as a percussionist, people generally think that that you play drums, like the snare drum. Peter did a great job, by the way. Peter was awesome on the drum set. But you play drums like the snare drum or the bass drum. But there's a whole host of other things that you can play. And I've shown some folks this before. But, you know, you've got things like go-go bells you can play. Or one of my favorites is the shaker. I was just trying this out last night, and it was making me think back to the 1980s. Walk like an Egyptian, right? So you get to play all sorts of instruments, but then, of course, there was today's reading, and so that made me think back to my days as a percussionist. So you have crash cymbals, and crash cymbals have been around for thousands of years, 5,000 years or so, we think. We think they started out maybe in Turkey, parts of the Middle East, and some of their first uses were in military purposes, because imagine you have a whole host of people who have crash cymbals, and you're on the opposite side of this, and you're about to do battle, and all of a sudden you hear a bunch of crash cymbals playing. That would put the fear of God in you, right? So crash cymbals can be fun when you're a percussionist, because it really wakes people up. Any babies sleeping? No, I don't think so. Good, okay, thank you. I just wanted to make sure, but you can play them kind of softly. You can get them a little bit louder, or you can play them really loud. And that's fun, especially out at a marching field. I really wanted to show you a gong, but of course I couldn't find one. I'm just kidding, I couldn't help myself. If you're going to read about gongs, then you're going to show off a gong, thank you. So the thing about gongs is that you want to make sure that they're already vibrating a little bit when you really hit them, because otherwise it's not a really good noise. But so gongs have been around for at least like 1,500 years. And we think they started maybe in China and Tibet, and they've been used for a whole host of purposes. But you just kind of pre-hit it a little bit here. You don't hit in the middle, because that's not good, but you hit around it, and then... Yeah. That brings back memories of the gong show for some people, probably. Or perhaps the end of the opening number for the Muppet Show. That'll take... Okay, I'll tamp it down. This is a tam-tam, a kind of gong. I'll move it back here so it doesn't distract you all. So the thing about percussion instruments is that by themselves, they may seem kind of random, but they're really important when it comes to the bigger context of things. So when we get to read 1 Corinthians 13, and I get to read that at weddings and funerals a lot, and the part that people think about first is love is patient and kind. Love is not envious or boastful or rude. It does not insist on its own way, but insists in the truth. That kind of thing, and it's beautiful to hear those words. And Paul technically isn't really describing romantic love per se. He's talking more about this idea of Christian love, loving your neighbor, loving God. It just so happens to overlap a little bit with romantic love, because hopefully we're treating our spouse with love and respect, with patience and kindness as well. But this first part from chapter 13 of 1 Corinthians, it really strikes me, and that's a percussionist joke, because that's what strike. Anyway. Verse 1 really strikes me, because as a percussionist, I like to think that gongs and cymbals and auxiliary percussion are really important, because otherwise, why would we play them? Paul seems to kind of be dissing these a little bit. And they're kind of fun. I wish Paul had a chance to come back here and try some of these instruments. But Paul's suggesting that by themselves and without a purpose, a cymbal or a gong can potentially get downright annoying. And I know about my mom, and if you're the mom of a percussionist, for example, you know that listening to the sound of drums on and on and on can test your love and patience for your children, because it is very, very loud. And Paul is suggesting that life can be like that too. If we do wonderful things, if we accomplish all sorts of stuff, but we don't have love in our lives, then it's kind of like playing a gong or a cymbal just on its own. It doesn't really have a wider purpose. You know, I went to my 25th college reunion recently, and I have some classmates who have done and who are doing some really impressive things. I kind of try not to compare myself to some of the things that these folks are doing. But then I think to myself, I don't know for sure if they have love in their lives. And for me, the fact that I have that love in my heart and love for God and love for neighbor means that hopefully what I am doing has that purpose and that ability to express itself and share with other people. Because when you have divine love in your heart and in your life, it can be the difference between just making a noise in your life for the sake of making a noise versus that versus making music and making a difference in the life of others for the benefit of your own heart, for the heart of others, and even for the heart of God. Living with love and doing ministry is kind of like playing the gong in Carmina Burana, or playing the cymbals in Tchaikovsky. Tchaikovsky loved cymbals. He was great. If you liked percussion, listen to Tchaikovsky all day long. He also liked cannons with 1812 Overture, but that's a whole other story. But the thing is that a noisy gong and a clanging cymbal, when they're a part of something bigger, then they have meaning and purpose in a way that they don't just by themselves. And without love, our lives can be like that too. Paul is saying in these few words that if you have agape love in your life, then you can really honor the whole body of Christ, those who are honored by the world and those who are marginalized as well. I think our music ministry seeks to bring together and succeeds, I believe, in bringing together people to praise God with joy for the gift of life. I see our music ministry joyfully giving God thanks for the gift of music. Our choirs sing and they play with the love of God in their hearts, love of neighbor in their hearts, expressed in working together and helping direct the rest of us as a congregation experience love and joy. This past year I've had an opportunity, for example, to get to play in the handbell choir, something I got to do when I was a teenager, but not much since. And you get to experience the love of neighbor when you work together and collaborate. You rely on the other folks to play the notes at the right time. I recall back on our Maundy Thursday service when Wonjung sang that verse of "Were You There?" And I experienced firsthand the love that she was expressing for Jesus and God in memory of suffering on the cross. That love and that sorrow were tangible in the notes that she sang. So too with our youth choir and our adult choir, as they sing, "How can I keep from singing exactly right?" With love in our hearts, how can we keep from singing and glorifying God? It's true that people can make joyful noises to God in other contexts other than in a place of worship. Some of you may not be bold to sing in public, but maybe you sing in the shower or in the car or elsewhere. Maybe you sing to your kids to sing them to sleep. Those are wonderful blessings to do those things, a celebration of the gift of music. But here in this church, we are intentional and forthright that music is both a celebration of life and a gift from God. So while other music may lift up love in all its many forms, here we lift up love as something that is patient and kind. Love believes all things, hopes all things, bears all things, endures all things. Love never ends. God's love never ends, and so we can always praise God for that. The good news today is that anyone with some of that patient love can lift up praises and songs here, because we seek to let that faithful love abide in our hearts and sing out in these four walls and beyond. There is a place for everyone in this church's music ministry, maybe even for someone who plays the gong. But thanks be to God, and amen. So now let us join our hearts in a spirit of prayer. In humble prayer, we approach you, O God, even though you have been with us this whole time. God, there's so much that we lift up to you. This week, God, we pray with added understanding for people across the world who deal with poor air quality. We especially pray for those who suffer from breathing challenges. Bless, O God, the firefighters from Canada and around the world as they seek to tame the flames that have risen in eastern Canada. We pray for those who mourn, that they shall be comforted, as we name now some of those who have recently died. We pray for Jack. We pray for Sharon. But God, grant those who mourn Easter hope. God, we, in the midst of emotional and medical challenges, reach out to you for mercy and grace. Be with those who are hurting in body or in spirit, as we name some now. We pray for David. We pray for Diana. Grant them your healing spirit. We give thanks to God for graduates, those who are graduating high school and all different levels of education, that they may move ahead with greater education. May you continue to inspire them and guide them. We give thanks for the wedding next weekend of Jillian and Michael. Bless their marriage and bless all of those who lift them up in love. We thank you for the good vibrations of music, for this people and your spirit, for the voices that emanate in song here each and every Sunday. Thank you for the gift of music in its various and wonderful forms. Bless Wan Jung and her continued music ministry, and bless each voice as it expresses love for you. We pray this all in Jesus' holy name. Amen. So on behalf of the congregation, I want to thank the music ministry slash committee for all their wise guidance and work this year related to the church's music. That includes Chuck Roy and Lisa Roy and Sean Jeffrey and Debbie Mastroni Kenyon and our chairperson, Allison Gottsagen. Thank you all for your service this year. I also want to thank the Settled Music Search Committee for their work from December through May, which we will recognize more fully in the fall, but now I just want to at least mention the members of that committee by name. Allison Gottsagen again, Robin Lewis, Mary Miller, Chuck Roy, Jessica Turner, and the co-chairs of the search committee, Gretchen and Steve Parrott. Thank you for your dedication to this church's music ministry.
Today we especially give thanks for the many musicians who have filled and lifted their voices and their instruments in praise this year, particularly today, bringing it to final culmination. Our youth choir, the newly formed youth band, our handbell choir, the meeting house ringers, and the anchor of all of our ensembles, the adult choir. We also give thanks for soloists like Gretchen and Steve Parrott, Will Rydell, substitute keyboardists Jimmy Jeffrey, and others. We give thanks and thank God for Robin Lewis, who coordinated much of the music in the fall through Christmas, playing the piano on many Sundays, and I am particularly grateful for her for filling that void for me. We also, most of all, we thank God for Wan Jung Chu, who jumped right into the music ministry last fall, who brings a strong spirit and out-of-the-box thinking, who has encouraged people to explore new adventures in making music, and who cares so deeply about praising God, from whom all blessings flow. We are truly blessed, Wan Jung. We are grateful for your ministry, and we celebrate you today as we complete your interim work with us through the end of July. And Wan Jung, on behalf of the music committee, we have flowers for you. You have truly been a blessing to us. Very thankful to everyone who participated in the music ministry, and please, there's more opportunity. You will notice that there is an insert in the bulletin. for you to share your gifts with us as we move forward. Please fill them out, put them in the collection plate, give them to me. We feel very blessed that we have so many talented people. Thank you.
We give Allison a little bit of a head start to get upstairs. Once again, we're grateful for for everyone, and we invite you after worship downstairs for a reception in our coffee hour, and thank you, Ann Sabo, for that. But now, we're going to join together in singing a very appropriate hymn, When in Our Music God is Glorified, which is hymn number 561 in your black-covered New Century hymnals. Let us praise God together. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit go with you both now and forevermore. Amen.